But there's also another story, and that is the story of the aggressive campaign, anti-establishment campaign, being run by Bernie Sanders. And you could argue that Sanders winning more than 100 delegates last night potentially outperformed some of the expectations that some have had. And the question is, will the Jersey primary then be relevant for this very grassroots and what seems to be skewing very young millennials supporting Bernie Sanders against the establishment pick in Hillary Clinton? To weigh in on that, I've got my good friend Chris Haan. Chris Haan is a syndicated radio host, and I like to call him an unapologetic progressive. Chris, how are you, man? Good morning.
Nothing to apologize for. That's
of course.
So, how you doing, man? I'm doing great.
I'm doing great too. I you know, of course, you and I have talked about this, you know, on your show, and you've been here. That this is one of the most exciting presidential contests of our lifetime. I love this.
I'm loving every minute of it on both sides. I think it's just been there's been a lot to talk about. There's been a lot of strategy. You know, I'm sure Roger Stone pointed out in your last segment that there's been a substantial shift in strategy for Donald Trump over the last week, which might actually help him seal the deal.
What about the Democrat side, though, Chris? Here, my take is that you've got Bernie Sanders effectively, and you're going to listen. When do you hear this? I've been very positive about Bernie because I think he has captured some of the hearts and minds of the younger Democrats. I don't think it's his policies that is doing it. I think it's this, you know, anti-establishment. And I've pointed out that because of the way the superdelegates are set up in the Democratic Party, it makes that process very difficult for an outsider, even more difficult, I think, than on the Republican side.
Well, yeah, the Republicans, you know, they have fewer superdelegates. There's this misconception that they have none, but they have a couple. But they also have fewer delegates overall. But it's a look, I think what he's done is he's been coming out with some ideas that are appealing to the younger generation and certain people who may be a little bit older. But those ideas are not backed up with any real policy or any real substance. And I think that's probably what hurt him in New York, where New Yorkers knew Hillary Clinton, knew that she was a person of substance and didn't buy into a lot of his, you know, dreams. Look, he did very well here. He performed exactly 1 point better than I thought he would. So literally 1 point. I had about 41%. He got 42%, barely.
Well, and he got more than 100 delegates. What about Jersey, though, Chris? What happens when you get back here and cross the Hudson? Does Bernie outperform his performance in New York? Because the expectation is that Trump is going to do as well, if not better.
Right. I think that by the time we get to New Jersey, the Democratic contest will be a very different contest. By then, it is very likely that Hillary will be at the number she needs for the nomination or very close to it without superdelegates. So, I mean, I saw Bernie's campaign manager last night talking about, you know, how they're going to contest the convention no matter what. I think that's a little bit, I think he's just angry with the way things went down last night because they were predicting a win as recently as this time yesterday.
Wow.
And in politics, you don't manage expectations like that. You downplay expectations. The Clinton team was saying, well, we think it'll be a single point win, and they got a double point win.
Right.
And it's, you know, it was very odd to see him on TV last night. Talking about his path to victory, which, you know, look, he's not going to do well in these Northeast states that demographically favor Hillary Clinton. I mean, African-American Latino voters are overwhelmingly supporting Hillary Clinton, as are older white voters in the Democratic Party primary.
Do you see the potential for a ticket to unite the party? Is that even necessary, a Hillary Clinton-Bernie Sanders ticket, or is this the high watermark and he's on the way out?
No, I think this is the high water mark. I think that Bernie Sanders will have a big role at the convention. I think he'll have a big role in picking the agenda. I think that in the next couple of days, you'll start to see him tone down his rhetoric against Secretary Clinton, because I think that there's got to have to be a certain come to Jesus moment in his campaign where they understand that this is now a movement and not actually a campaign to win the nomination of the party.
That's well said.